Upper and lower flow regime is effectively the relationship between the average flow velocity and the average grain size of sediments in motion, reflecting on how sediments are transported and corresponding stratification planes are formed. It is important to recognize the bed forms as to understand the type of depositional environment and furthermore carry out reservoir modeling. The following graph can be used to describe the different flow regimes. This line represents the split between the two. The lower flow regime includes dunes, ripples, and lower plain beds, along with no movement scenarios, generally lower energy environments. The mean sediment diameter represents the size of the grains. Sands and smaller gravels are the main focus of this graph, as silts typically have a grain size of less than 63 micrometers or 0.063 millimeters, but are nonetheless included. Ripples are defined as wave-shaped build-up of sediments, typically caused by smaller grains moving at a relatively slow velocity. In beach-like environments, where the direction of flow continues to change directions, ripples tend to maintain a fairly symmetrical bell-shaped curve. In rivers, they may tend to be slanted towards the movement when it is unidirectional. Slanted ripples may resemble dunes that can be misinterpreted in geological records. Based on their grain size and the amplitude of the sedimentary wave, they can be distinguished. Ripples tend to be created by small sediments and are defined to have an amplitude of less than 10 centimeters. Dunes can be much bigger and tend to be so in onshore environments, where winds is the main mode of sediment transportation. This is possible as smaller sediments located in the ripples area have too much energy to settle and are therefore suspended in the air. Sediment transportation can be shown in a few different processes.
There are multiple different types of sedimentation transportation when it comes to upper and lower flow regimes. Traction is the first type of transportation in which involves the sediments rolling along the lower portion of the bed. This occurs when the flow of the fluid has enough energy to drag the grain along the surface without lifting it. Fluid movement, whether it flows as laminar or turbulent, does not affect bed load grain transportation as the grain is possibly too large to be elevated. Bed loading normally produces ripples and dunes as the sediments build up. This simply does not have enough energy to skip over the build up and therefore gets piled up. Particles that have enough energy with turbulent flow can be lifted off the bed surface. These can be defined as suspended loads. Uplift due to the turbulent water causes the sediments to move in unpredictable directions, which in turn causes the sediments to remain suspended until energy is insufficient and they begin to fall. During this process, collision of the sediment particles may occur, taking longer for the sediment particles to rest on the bed. Siltation occurs when high enough energy is present to lift the sediments. The turbulent flow raises the grain until it does not have sufficient energy to be suspended, creating the leaping effect. Uninterrupted siltation occurs when the grain make a clear path without colliding with other grains. If collision occurs, the grain may gain slightly more energy and travel a different range. This is known as interrupted siltation. Whether the range is increased or decreased is dependent on the point of contact between the two. Solution is the final occurrence where the minerals of sediments is small enough to dissolve into the solute. This essentially removes some of the more chemically unstable minerals from the formation of the bed form.
Lower plain beds are effectively the first structure formed when sandy grains are exposed to low energy movement, mainly bed load motion. They are a transition stage into dunes and typically removed in the geological record. Dunes will be formed as the fluid velocity increases over time. Let's say that in this instance, a new source of smaller grains is then carried into the same velocity fluid. Those dunes will start to be covered in ripples and have enough energy to dislodge others and carry them along, once again forming plain stratification. Unlike the lower plain beds, upper plain beds can be maintained in a depositional environment long enough to be held within a rock record. This is known as a planar stratification. Further increasing energy will begin to create anti-dunes. Supercritical flow exists when flow number is above 1 and can be described as when the fluid velocity is higher than the wave velocity, resulting in a hydraulic jump. This jump forms the antidune shape and the fluid flows in phase with it, forming more antidunes in succession. Dunes differ from antidunes because the fluid is not in phase when it comes to dunes. The surface of the fluid is relatively flat.
Blanketing is a rare form of bed form formation where sediments suddenly experience no movement and simply fall and blanket the uppermost bed. This usually occurs when air transported grains land in a still body of water, such as a lake. The sediments on top of the plain bed will be deposited uniformly. Overall, if the conditions of both grain size and average mean velocity are maintained constant for enough time, the bed forms in the shown graph will be formed as solid strata.